All right. So, let's get to the pants, I guess. All right. So, I'm going to use sweatpants because they're easy. They're loose. And I'll go over the shorts. Because we're going to keep this G-rated as much as possible. So, I got my legs up, and it's just dialing in one leg at a time. As I usually bring all the way up to my ankle. Key is, keep it below your knee at first, so you can get your other leg in there. So I'll bring my other leg up. So I'm going to act right, and I will put the other leg in. Alright. So then after that, I'll pull over the knees and I'll dress them up. Pull my slack above my knees. Like natural, and I'll just throw my legs out. So what I'm doing, I'll throw my legs out, stretching them out, so I can roll around and pull my pants up. So pull them out, and they'll spasm and stiffen. Do their little deal because they're hard headed, and then I can just take it. It's gonna be a little bit harder, but I'm gonna work and do my best. This is where the rolling in comes in. Take my momentum and I'll go around. I'll pull the front up a little bit in the back. I was showing this in another video, but it is really easier if you'll take and turn your head upside down and grab the seam of your pants, like that. And you can pull with less force. You're not fighting as much. If you'll just do like that, don't rip them, but pull them up like that. And then you can roll over the other side. This is where I grab the momentum and I grab the wheelchair and pull myself over. And I'll do the other side. Again, turning my head upside down, grab the seam. And easy peasy. I'll just correct them. Usually I'll roll, as I'm already on this side, I'll roll to the other side to correct that one to make sure it is correct. And it's not, so it is now. Now, fold my pockets in, and this is a pair of blue jeans. I'm ready for my shoes and work. That's it. Other than that, I'm actually ready for bed. Of course, I'm not wearing these like this. I'll be hot. But either way, I'm ready. But if I were ready to go to work, for the most part, we'll put both shoes on and I'll transfer out. And that'll be the end of it, I guess. That'll get everybody going. That should get you going in the morning or in the afternoon or to the kitchen to cook or tend to the kids, whatever you gotta do. So, who needs a gym, right? So there's one shoe. And here's another shoe. And we have shoes. And I don't like, I can't feel it, but what we all worry about is damaging our legs. Because we don't have a lot of, if we sit in our chair too long, without stretching and anything, moving around, you don't have a lot of blood flow. So it's not good to damage or scar up or hit your legs. So as much as possible, I can take my legs and I can throw them over the edge. It's no problem. It gives me momentum and it helps me get up. But I don't want to hit. This wheelchair is not my permanent wheelchair. My other one's on order. But this pipe on the end, I don't want to scar my leg with this pipe. So this wheelchair has been great to me. But throw caution to the wind, I don't want to damage myself either. So I will still use it as momentum. And I will simply, you can just lay them over, it's not hard. Laying them over, and I'll roll on my elbow. It's easy. It's just momentum, and it's the transfer of weight is all you're doing. And I'll use my elbow to roll onto. Just placing my elbow down, momentum of my legs, because I weigh a lot more than you think, and I'll just roll up. Easy peasy. Of course, then I don't feel comfortable unless I fix my pants. So in the morning, as my wife's getting the kids ready for school, I'm getting dressed, and she's screaming at me, and I'm waiting on her to come get me. I'll get dressed. Yeah, I'll get up and get dressed in the morning. So transferring from here to there is upper body strength that you learn in rehab, and then I really enjoy this apartment that we moved into because I'm on the main level. I had to come out of another one after the injury. I'm on the main level. And the gym here is perfect. It has a center console, a cable machine, to where I can put my wheelchair in any way, form or fashion, and do a lot of different things on the cable, work up my upper body. And it has worked well because 180 pounds, 190 pounds, whatever, I'm deadlifting. So it's all about momentum and position, and you work on your transfer, you really don't drag. Yes, you'll learn that it'll wear you out worse. I kind of got off the slide board about a week after I got out. You kind of just don't want to do it. You want to do better, so I still have it. But I learned to get into my vehicle, my SUV, without it. So, just do it. I've come close to falling on the floor 100 times with this gap. If I didn't make it, then I'd be halfway in between supporting myself. And I had to fight to push up, or in the mornings if I don't stretch, my back won't work and it'll want to bend my legs. My muscles will want to contract. And it'll bend my legs up under here, and I'll almost go on the floor. It's a lot of different scenarios. Stretching is key, it really is. So, if I'm here, and I have my legs placed, I'm going to close this gap a little bit, so I'm kind of halfway straddling it. And I'll just transfer. Easy peasy. Just like that. So, then I'll, this particular wheelchair is removable legs. And it folds. It's convenient, somewhat. It's been real good to me, but I would initially just turn my supports around and put my legs up in here, and I'm ready to go. Other than that, I'm ready to get to bed for whatever reason at the end of the evening. And so now I'm just going to make sure I'm at a better angle. If you can close this gap any, is the best thing you can do. So usually I'm at an angle. I come back as far as I can, and I'll lock them down for now because I'm still a little wobbly. And I'll transfer over, so I'll pick myself up. Throughout the day, they talk about pressure reliefs. The best way to perform them easily and with less energy is to just practice them throughout the day as much as possible. But also, while you're not doing anything, if you can, just do this. That's it. All you're doing is helping yourself. You're building your shoulders, your chest, your arms, the back part of your arms is what's key. That's what you need to help transfer as much as possible. Most of it's about technique as well. Because I've seen some people that were half the size of me and they could throw themselves around easily. It's all about technique and what works better for you. Mine's a little bit different as far as how much weight I have to deal around on a day-to-day basis. So up and down. I used to do this all the time when I got in this wheelchair and got out on my own, got at home. Because all I wanted to do was to be able to move myself with the less amount of force as I could. So at the end of the day, I will put myself to the front of the seat. And usually I'll grab the chair. the tire and put my hand on the bed right here, and I will pick up and just scooch over. Quite simple. That's it. Easy peasy. And then a little trick I learned on another video that I watched was I would just take my legs and grab them and pull them up with me. And I am here. Easy peasy. Shoes are off. I'm pulling again on my elbow, rolling over. Fairly easy, just like coming off. It does take practice though. I don't think it's gonna happen overnight. Don't get discouraged either, because it's not gonna happen overnight. Momentum. Show you a little shot, don't tell nobody. Get everybody excited. Alright. And I'm up. Alright, so coming up. My therapist, she would push me and I would push her, and this is what helped me. So if you're here as much as possible, if you can stay here and do some practice, you're up, you're down. It don't seem like much, but you're working as much as you can on those arms, and it helps. So I would just take these off. And I think my wife says we're about to run out of time, so good luck. And let me know if you need anything. You know where to reach me. Thanks.